Welcome to the course Unconventional Machining Process. In this session, we are going to learn about the abrasive flow machining process, working principles and equipments used. Need for advanced finishing processes. Grinding, labbing and honing are the traditional finishing processes. The most time consuming and labor demanding section of the manufacturing process in today's industry is the final finishing of complex and precision works. Further, finishing operations usually cost approximately 15% of the total machining cost in a production cycle. In view of this, a need of automated finishing operations to substitute the manual finishing operations is felt. To meet such requirements, a non-traditional finishing process named as abrasive flow machining has been developed. Abrasive flow machining process was developed by Extrude Horn Corporation, USA in 1960. It is a non-traditional machining method that can be used to deferring, radiusing, polishing, removing recast layers, producing compressive residual stresses, etc. Because of its capability to machine interior and curved surfaces, it is considered as a suitable surface finishing process to finish internal complex geometry of workpiece. The effect of this non-conventional mechanical machining occurs at nanometer scale, obtaining surface roughness under RA of 100 nanometer. Principle of AFM. We can understand from this particular diagram in which the AFM is a kind of finishing process in which a small quantity of material is removed by flowing a semi-solid media, that is comprises of a carrier in the form of a polymer base containing abrasive powders over the surface to be machined. AFM in which two vertically opposed cylinders extrude medium back and forth through passages formed by the workpiece and tooling or by workpiece alone. Force may be applied hydraulically or mechanically. Velocity of media is governed by the cross-sectional area of passageways. Abrasion occurs only where the flow of the media is restricted. Other areas remain unaffected. Abrasive particles act as cutting tools, hence it is a multi-point cutting process giving very low MRR. It is employed both for metals and non-metals. Schematic diagram of AFM process is given in this particular diagram in which we find the hydraulic unit, pressure gauge, AC motor and the pump, and it is connected to the upper hydraulic cylinder and lower hydraulic cylinder through the four hoses, and the bottom of upper hydraulic cylinder we have upper medium cylinder, and top of lower hydraulic cylinder we have the lower medium cylinder. In between both medium cylinders we can place the workpiece fixture in which we can place the workpiece, and the medium is filled in between. The key components of AFM system are 1. Machine, one-way AFM, two-way AFM or orbital AFM. Tooling, workpiece, drill bit, fixture plate, fixture, piston, cylinder. Abrasive media, the media that is needed to be polished, tapered or finished. It consists of face material, abrasive grits and plasticizer. AFM machine, we can see from this particular diagram, it uses two vertically opposed hydraulic cylinders which extrude medium back and forth from one cylinder to another with the help of a hydraulic ram. These cylinders are clamped together with the workpiece sandwiched between them. Control system can be added to monitor and control additional process parameters such as temperature, viscosity, wear and flow speed of the media. Abrasion occurs wherever the medium passes through the highly restrictive passage. The media extruding pressure ranges from 0.70 to 22 megapascal. This is the one-way AFM for falsely through cavity. It pushes abrasive media through the workpiece only in one direction, allowing the media to exist freely from the part. It has advantages of faster cycle processing, able to process larger parts, simple tooling and part changeover, easy cleanup. The examples of the components are machined by this is engine block and the multiple holes. Second type of AFM process is two-way AFM. It is used for through cavity. In this process, two vertically opposite cylinders to extrude an abrasive media back and forth through or around passages formed by the workpiece and tooling. Abrasive action occurs wherever the media enters and passes through the most restrictive passages. It has the advantages of excellent process control, can finish both ID and OD of component, faster setup and quick change tooling, faster changeover of media. Examples for this, we can machine this kind of tie and mold. Third one is orbital AFM, mainly used for plane cavity. Surface and edge finishing are achieved by rapid low amplitude and the acceleration of the workpiece related to a self-forming elastic plastic abrasive polishing tool. It reduces or eliminates skilled hand finishing, applicable for job shop and production shops. Then tooling, that is workpiece jig and mixers. We can see from this particular diagram, the tooling is used to confine and direct the flow of media to the appropriate areas. The basic principle of tooling design in AFM system is to selectively permit or block the flow of media into or out of workpiece passages where tapering, radiusing and surface improvements are desired. Tooling of AFM machine is designed with two aims: to hold the parts in position and to contain the media and direct its flow. Maximum machining takes place wherever there is a maximum restriction to the flow of abrasive. The media, the polymer abrasive medium which is used in this process, possesses easy flowability, better self-deformability and the fine abrading capability. AFM media is pliable material which is a resilient enough to act as a self-deforming grinding stone when forced through a passageway. Types of abrasive used are aluminum, silicon carbide, cubic boron carbide and diamond. These abrasives are available in different grid sizes, ranges from 0.05 to 1.5 mm. The better the starting finish, the smaller the grid sizes used for finish processing. Here we have the lower viscosity media and higher viscosity media for the requirement. The larger abrasive cuts at a faster rate, while the smaller sizes provide their finishes and accessibility to small holes. It consists of base material, abrasive grids and plasticizers. The base material, that is viscoelastic or viscoplastic material, is made up of an organic polymer and hydrocarbon gel. Composition of base material determines its degree of stiffness. Thanks for watching this video. Thank you.